Hi guys, it's Sheena from Teton Raptor Center, and I'm here to give you all an update about the current patients that we're treating in our rehab facility. So let's go ahead and get started.
We're excited to announce that we recently released Swainson's Hawk 422, and this bird was found in Idaho Falls, presumably hit by a car. He came in with a pelvic fracture, as well as an old gunshot wound in his C7 vertebrae in his neck. And we're really thankful that the pelvic fracture healed and that the bullet is actually still going to be in his vertebrae, but that it's not going to impact him. Here's a photo of the x-ray that we took upon admit, and I circled the cervical spine where the pellet is in his neck from the old gunshot wound, and I also circled his pelvic fracture. Here is a video of Idaho Fish and Game officers releasing Swainson's Hawk 422 back into the wild. We also released a sharp-shinned hawk that hit a window in Rafter J and was just mildly stunned. Here we have red-tailed hawk 525, and this bird was found in Jackson with an eye injury in his left eye. Right now, staff are treating the eye injury with medicated drops, and this is a photo of an eye stain that we did, which shows an eye ulcer in that green section of his eye. Next up is red-tailed hawk 511, who is admitted to TRC with some mild head trauma. We have moved this bird into a larger enclosure where she can fly around, and she's set to begin flight conditioning in the coming days. Here we have great horned owl 49, and this bird was initially admitted from Tetonia, Idaho, and was emaciated upon admit. This bird has gained weight nicely and is currently in flight conditioning. However, he's very out of shape, so we will expect a couple more weeks at least to get him in good shape, and then we will begin live prey testing. Next up is Golden Eagle 42, and this is the bird that was admitted from Farson, Wyoming with suspected lead poisoning. However, her blood work has indicated that she's probably dealing with some kidney issues, so we are going to keep monitoring her blood work to see if we can find out any more information about that. Here we have American Kestrel 1012, and this bird is still dealing with some nerve damage in his wings, so we are currently staying the course, and he is still in flight conditioning with a new set of feathers to help him get around in the mew. And last but not least is Great Gray Owl 1010, and this bird has recently moved to an outdoor enclosure in hopes that the natural light and longer days will help to induce a molt.
Thanks guys for tuning in this week, and I look forward to talking with you all next week. Bye!